Hi everyone, welcome to our new video, how to import DXF file into Sheetcam and make it GCode. So first of all, we will go to file, select this import drawing, go to the folder where our file is saved. You can see here, my file name is anchor300.dxf. If you are working on an SVG file, you can select here SVG file and you will have the display of all the SVG files here, and you can select what file you want to convert into the G-code. So I'm converting my DXF file into the G-code. I select here DXF. It will show all the DXF files in my folder. Just come select it, open. Now it will ask scaling of the file. As this file was made by me, so I know it was scaled in metric, you know, in millimeters. So I am selecting here as metric. So sometimes you make files in inches, so you have to select here inches. So I am just selecting metric, making sure drawing position bottom left corner is my 0, 0. Sometimes you select center on 0, 0. So this means your X and Y axis are 0 at the center of the drawing. So I usually do left bottom as my X and Y axis, 0 positions. So now use points for drilling. It will show the plus sign on the drill points. You don't need to have click or not click it. Okay, use draw, use color as layer names. No need to use drawing name as part name. You can select yes or not. Okay, just your part name will be as your drawing name. Select OK. Here you know anchor 300. This is your part name. So part name is same as the drawing name. So you have successfully imported the DXF file into your Sheetcam. So here, in the last video, we made the tools. We made our tools here. Okay. So you can check out the last video how to make tools here. So in this video, I'll just go to the operations and, you know, just go to the operations, select outside offset. Outside offset means your tool will cut the line from outside of the area. So you have this inside material will be solid and will have the same dimensions as you mentioned in the drawing. So when you select inside offset means to cut the line from inside of the area. You can see here, this is showing your tool. Tool is cutting the line from inside, and you can just see it. Tool is cutting from the outside. Outside means this area will be your metal, your solid metal. Or when you cut inside, this area will be your cut area, and outside will be your metal. So this area of the metal will fall down during cutting. So we will select outside offset. Make sure your tool will be cutting the outside main line, the outline of the design from outside. Select layer one. No, you know, don't need to know here. Okay, now which tool I'll be using to cut this? I have selected my plasma 1.5 mm curve. You can obviously change here. Curve width. I told you earlier in the previous video, 1.5 mm is my curve width. You can select what your nozzle has. Feed rate, I'm cutting 3 mm mild steel, so my feed rate is 3000 millimeter per minute. This is according to your machine. What air pressure do you have at your machine? What is the ampere value you have set on your plasma cutter? So this depends on you. You can just, you know, do multiple cuts and hit and trial method, you know, so get what exactly the feed rate is best for your machine. Okay, pierce delay 0.5 second. All of these values I have discussed in my previous video. Just select okay. You can also edit feed rate here. Max channel length, I don't need in this file. Okay, lead in, I usually use as arc. Lead in, what is lead in and what is lead out? I use arc with 3 mm length. So lead in means when cutting the line from inside of the material, it start the cuts 3 mm before going to the actual light. You will see it here. Just select OK. No need to, you know, edit these values. 0.75 mm. This is sharp corners. You want to have sharp corners with loop size of 0 or whatever. So don't need. You have to make sure you select these values. Select OK. This is the your inside cutting because this is a hole. So here you can see this is 3 mm arc lead in. So it will go 3 mm from inside cut the material, then go to just cut the line, and then from here it will lead out 3 mm more into the distance material. Same with this line. It will enter at this point, 3 mm extra. It will cut in the outside of the material, that is, you know, wastage material. Then it will go and cut whole line, and then come back at this point, 3 mm more at the lead out value. Okay, so this is how you use the operations on your. And then make sure, go to options, machine, make sure you have selected jet cutting machine and post processor. What post processor you use? I have my machine, I have Mac 3 plus Mac 3 at my machine. You may have Mac 3, you may have Gerber, you may have NC Studio, whatever you have. So I have Mac 3, I have selected this. I have no Z, that doesn't matter because I have separate height controller for the Z axis. So I'm checking no Z. Output file extension I need is tab file. And output file units metric, you can use it in inches if your Mac 3 works in inches. I have my Mac 3 in metric, so I'm using it as metric. Set OK. Just go on this P, run the post processor, and just save the files. So it will save my file as there. Post processing completed, and you read this value. Just say OK. OK, now I'm going to this folder. Here my values. My G-code is saved, you know, anchor 300, this is my G-code. So thank you for watching this video. I hope you like it. If you have any question regarding CNC plasma cutting, G-codes, Sheetcam, Adobe Illustrator, CNC wood routers, and Inkscape, and everything regarding CNC machines, CNC cutting, designing, you can ask, and I'll try to help you as much as I can. Thank you.